This episode is brought to you by Skillshare. The first 1,000 people to sign up using the link in the description will get their first 2 months free.
500 years ago, roughly only half of the Earth had been thoroughly explored and colonized, and the Americas were home to indigenous civilizations, but were largely unknown to the rest of the world. People lived and died in the same houses, or at best, could aspire to end their lives no more than a few miles from where they were born. Yet today, globalism has connected the planet, and for most of the world, your future is in your own hands. The jet engine and the internet have brought us opportunities that can take us around the Earth, while modern medicine keeps pushing the limits of our mortality. But what might the future hold? Welcome to this episode of the Infographics Show, where we take a look at what life on Earth might look like in 50, 100, and 500 years. 50 years ago, the computer was just starting to replace slide rules in the most advanced industries of the most modern nations. But today, handheld cell phones, with many thousands of times the computing power, are in the hands of most people around the world. Per Moore's law, computing power doubles every 18 months, and for decades, this law has held true. Yet today, that law is being tested as our computer chips are reaching the very physical limits of the material they are constructed from. In short, we are starting to hit the maximum efficiency limits we can reach with physical materials. Enter quantum computing. While incredibly complex to fully explain, the basics of quantum computing is that it will allow us to bypass the limits of physical materials, as instead of using voltage or charge to store information, it does so with subatomic particles, making quantum computers exponentially faster than a conventional computer. In 50 years, we will likely see quantum computers replace conventional computers on a massive scale, even while new materials science continues to push the limits of conventional computing. You likely won't be carrying around a quantum phone, but your desktop at home will be a quantum computer. All of this raw computational power, combined with advanced AI, will give humanity the ability to exponentially accelerate its ability to solve problems and conduct research, greatly increasing the pace of new discoveries. All of this new computing power will revolutionize artificial intelligence, likely bringing about the technological singularity, or the point at which our technology becomes more intelligent than us. While many people fear this event, it is mostly due to a gross misunderstanding of intelligence. All intelligence is, after all, not equal. For example, you are vastly more intelligent than a monkey, but if you were transported to a rainforest and left there to fend for yourself, the monkey could be considered the more intelligent animal, as it knows how to survive in that environment, and you likely don't. In that case, we would consider the monkey to have a specialized intelligence that surpasses your own in that specific circumstance. It does not have the raw capabilities that you have, but in one specific area, it is far more intelligent than you. This is likely the route that artificial intelligence will take in 50 years. Machines will become hyper-intelligent, but will become specialized intelligences that are incredibly efficient in one specific area, while all but inept in any other. This is likely simply due to the nature of programming, as an intelligent machine will still need a human programmer, for now, to teach it what to use its intelligence for, and programming something as complex as the human brain that can do a nearly infinite number of things well is incredibly challenging, if not impossible, for a human programmer. But programming a machine for a small number of tasks is relatively easy. So in 50 years, we will have hyper-intelligent AIs to assist us in every facet of our lives, but need not live in fear of them wishing to overthrow us. All that machine intelligence will lead to things such as wearable technology that can monitor our health and warn us of pending illnesses, or by learning our biological patterns over weeks and months, even be able to predict when we will get sick, depressed, or stressed out, offering mood forecasts. For example, your smart wearable may pick up on the unique patterns of your brain and body that will let it know you are becoming more stressed out and be able to recommend diet changes or activities to take to avoid increased stress in the near future. By linking these wearables together over the internet, doctors will be able to prescribe treatments and medicines that are uniquely tailored to your specific biology, greatly increasing the effectiveness of medical treatments. In 50 years, advances in nanomanufacturing will revolutionize the world in ways that can be difficult to predict. By manufacturing materials at the molecular level, we will create materials that are hundreds of times stronger or more electrically conductive than today's. The energy efficiency of our cities will skyrocket, greatly reducing the demands placed on power plants. Vehicles made from nano-manufactured materials may be all but indestructible, saving millions of lives every year. Nanomedicine will also allow tiny robots and genetically engineered viruses to attack disease and infection on the molecular level, eliminating the side effects of drugs and greatly increasing our resistance to disease. In 50 years, each human may be host to millions of tiny robots who constantly patrol the body like artificial white blood cells, constantly attacking cancers, viruses, and other illnesses. Being sick may be a thing of the past. Most scientists are pretty confident that we will have mastered nuclear fusion within 50 years, giving humanity access to abundant and very cheap, clean energy. Unfortunately, the consequences of global warming are not likely to be averted, though a growing awareness of the threat we face is helping to limit the inevitable damage we will cause to our planet. Global temperatures will likely rise by a degree to a degree and a half Celsius, which will see the dying of most coral reefs around the world, and along with them, the vast majority of fish species that rely on them. Sea levels will rise by anywhere between 1 to 3 inches, making flooding a constant and ongoing threat to most coastal cities. The Arctic may become completely ice-free during the summer for the first time in history, driving polar bears and some seal species to extinction. On a positive note though, humanity may begin the process of transplanting warm water corals, such as those that grow in the Persian Gulf and the Red Sea, around the world. Adapted to the warmer temperatures, these coral reefs could, in a few hundred years, completely replace the old reefs, bringing back fish populations and diversity. The melting of the Arctic will also open up the last of the world's untouched fish stocks and underwater energy reserves, helping to stave off a complete energy and commercial fishing collapse. And absolutely nobody will be killed by polar bears anymore. That's a lot of change for us in 50 years, a lot good, but some pretty bad. Still, there's hope for us if we learn to manage the world and its resources in a responsible way and use powerful new technologies to aid us in that endeavor. So what will life look like in 200 years? That becomes more difficult to predict and relies heavily on how we choose to spend the next 50 years. However, some trends can be easily predicted and some optimistic guesses can be made. While global populations will explode in the next 200 years, the rate of growth is predicted to slow dramatically and not reach the apocalyptic standing room only predictions so popular with doomsayers today. This is because even today, population growth in the first world has slowed dramatically, and in some places, such as Japan, all but stalled. That's due to people living better lives and having more opportunities, thus choosing to wait longer to start families. As more of the world catches up to a modern way of living, the exploding populations of the third and second worlds will experience the same dramatic slowdown. So while humanity will grow well above the 10 billion mark, we almost certainly won't run the risk of dramatic overpopulation. Still, with a desire for greater personal freedom and to escape overpopulated megacities, humanity will move to the oceans both above and below them. Floating cities have already been designed by architects today, and future advancements in materials and manufacturing will make them a reality. People will live under the waves as well. The ocean retains the vast majority of the Earth's natural resources and is all but untouched. To feed a population of 15 to 20 billion, farming will also move offshore. Advances in genetic engineering will allow humanity to replace meat in most of our diets, and in fact, the primary food stock for all of humanity may be algae. Genetically engineered superalgae could be easily farmed and harvested in vast mid-ocean reserves, which are already mostly devoid of life, thus not harming any wildlife. The harvested algae could be reprocessed at the molecular level and manipulated to simulate the taste and even texture of nearly any food item, while avoiding the calories and fats of red meat and sweets. And while humanity certainly won't give up meat completely, instead of farming animals, we will instead create meat from scratch, a technology already under development. Lab-grown meats will be healthier, tastier, and cheaper to produce, bringing better and more delicious diets to people around the world while avoiding untold amounts of animal suffering and the staggering impact of traditional farming on our environment. Greater advancements in computing will likely see the creation of the first true artificial intelligences, though what they may be like is as of yet a complete unknown. We may in fact not even be able to communicate anything meaningful with these artificial intelligences, as simple evolutionary barriers could make them vastly psychologically different than us. That's because human intelligence is shaped by millions of years of evolutionary pressures, creating a unique psychology that operates on the basic principles of a need to sexually reproduce and compete for limited resources such as food, water, shelter, hunting ranges, etc. These basic tenets, need to procreate and compete for resources, are universal throughout all life. And we can predict that this holds true for even the strangest alien life, as even if you are a jellyfish from the Zalblarg Nebula, your ancestors still had to compete for whatever you eat as food and had to procreate. Even plants, who passively collect sunlight and carbon dioxide, compete against each other for the best, sunniest spots and to attract pollinators. However, an artificial intelligence will not have experienced any of these evolutionary pressures, and with a constant supply of power feeding its hardware and no imperative to reproduce in order to ensure its survival, will never face them. The psychology of such an intelligence and how it might think is beyond our scope of understanding at the moment, and may be forever. Thus, it's likely that artificial intelligence in the common science fiction sense will simply never exist, as we will have no imperative to create an intelligence we cannot communicate with or have any use for. What is likely is that humanity will instead continue to develop artificial intelligences that are useful, continuing the track of specialized intelligences that are hyper-intelligent in specific areas. We will likely hand over the reins of development over to these hyper-intelligences, allowing them to optimize themselves and stepping out of the creation loop entirely. These hyper-intelligences will continuously strive for greater and greater efficiency, creating constant updates to themselves that improve their capabilities, resulting in an explosion of capabilities that is all but impossible to predict. By harnessing these titanic intellects and directing them at our pressing problems, however, mankind will absolutely revolutionize itself and the world, solving in years or decades problems such as global warming, which may take us, today, centuries to fix. By this point, it's certain that man will begin to merge with his technology, everything from artificial and hyper-efficient organs to implants that directly increase our intelligence and ability to process information. Humanity will become a transhuman species, and combined with genetic engineering, completely remove ourselves from the process of evolution, putting its power to shape our bodies and minds completely in our own hands. With abundant clean energy and resources, poverty will become extinct. The standard of living around the world will become universal, which will eliminate the majority of sources for human conflict, creating an era of unparalleled peace and prosperity. Humanity will begin to take its first real steps to establishing itself outside of the Earth. What will begin as tourist destinations on the Moon and Mars will grow into actual colonies, though still heavily dependent on Earth. The exploitation of resources in space will begin in earnest well before 200 years from now. Companies on Earth are already mulling the possibilities of harvesting raw materials from asteroids. With the incredible wealth of materials available in asteroids throughout the solar system, humanity will have no shortage of materials to create a true spacefaring civilization. Life in 500 years becomes even more difficult to predict. After all, how could the first European settlers in America have possibly predicted the internet? Some predictions can still be made, though. With 500 years worth of computing, nanomanufacturing, and genetic engineering knowledge, disease and illness will likely be a thing of the past. People simply won't get sick anymore. Our bodies will host tiny implants that will monitor our health and create nanobots from the raw materials in the food we eat so it can combat any threat to our bodies. Regenerative medicine will allow for the growth of missing limbs, and genetic engineering will eradicate genetic disease entirely. Human lifespans will double or triple as we reprogram ourselves to stop deteriorating or simply replace them entirely with artificially created copies. We may even become immortal either by constantly regenerating our bodies or by simply uploading our consciousness to computers. Humanity will almost certainly have taken to the stars, but just how far is a complete unknown. While modern physics tells us that things such as the warp drive and its ability to cheat the speed limit of light is theoretically possible, our ability to ever actually create and power one is questionable at best. Unfortunately, the most realistic prediction for just how far into the stars humanity may get could be answered by observing space around us. Despite the Earth existing for billions of years, we still have no evidence that it was ever visited by aliens. And our planet is a latecomer to the galaxy, meaning other star systems have existed for far longer than us, meaning there is certainly life in our own galaxy that has been around for millions, if not billions, of years longer than us. With all that time to solve the problem of long-distance spaceflight, we still have no evidence for visitation. Perhaps we are simply in a backwater neighborhood, far away from where the rest of life evolved, but sadly, it's far more likely that the distance between all but the nearest stars is just too great, and humanity will never get further than its own neighborhood. Life is set to change in ways we could hardly imagine, and predicting life in 200 or even 500 years is almost impossible. Technology advances so rapidly that imagining future technologies is as impossible for us today as it would have been for the early European settlers to imagine the internet or spaceflight. What is clear, though, is that the world of tomorrow depends entirely on the choices we make today, and the inventions of our children will be shaped and guided by the values we instill in them today. Whether we teach our children to respect each other and the world they live in, or don't, will shape what our future looks like, and may in fact mean the difference between continuing to thrive or our complete extinction. Maybe you have a different view of what life on Earth will be like in the future. Why not learn how to make your own animated videos and show us? Skillshare has over 24,000 online classes to help you learn new skills or improve your old ones. With everything from animation to production to Photoshop, Skillshare has the tools you need to get started today. Skillshare is an online learning community with over 20,000 classes in criminal law, programming, drawing, and more. Premium membership will give you unlimited access to topics that will improve your skills and your life. Join the millions of other people who are using Skillshare and get 2 months for free. To sign up, go to skillshare.com/infographics35 or click the link in the description and start learning today. So, what do you think life will look like in the future? What future technology are you most excited about? Let us know in the comments. Also, be sure to check out our other video, What If You Only Drank Coke and Nothing Else? Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time!